in many conferences, they start by saying we should wait 5 or 10 minutes because more people will come. We're not going to wait. People come in. So they gotta respect the people that they are here and not the people that they assume that we're going to be late simply because we're Greeks or we're in Athens. Good morning to everybody. My name is Gregory Papanikos. I'm the president of this World Association of Academics and Researchers. We've been around for 30 years. We were established, we were conceived, I should say, in Canada in the 1980s. The idea was very simple, and honestly, what was is to make a place, Athens a place, where people from all over the world, they can come and exchange ideas. But we need an organization so that people, academics, they can write off expenses. You can see they're high. Otherwise, nobody would say, you have to have an organization so we can write off expenses. We have the money, but nothing goes on in Athens. And it was true 30 years ago. Even today, very few international, truly international conferences take place in Athens. So we have to find a model, because you cannot do anything without a model, at least in business and economics, not MBA. And searching for a model, we went back 2,500 years. And we found that just 500 meters away from here, there were some guys that they were organizing the same thing. And now it's in many languages in the world, they use it for conference, symposium. We don't use it because symposium has a very bad connotation, believe it or not. First of all, it means we drink together alcohol and other things that I'm not going to describe. But if you really want and are interested in it, you should read the conference proceedings of the most famous symposium in the world, edited by Plato. And it's called Plato's Symposium. So he has selected the best paper. Now you're not going to be, I see some people don't believe, but that's true. Selected the best papers, and he publishes them as conference proceedings of a symposium that took place 415 BC, almost 2,500 years ago, 500 meters from here. And of course, surprisingly not, the subject, the theme was Eros. What is Eros? Okay, so what I did though was something else. I took the logistics of that conference. And the logistics was that there were 2 or 3 hours. Everybody was speaking and the next follow. And at the end, they had a discussion. I even measured the time required to speak. The first speaker, it took him 8 minutes. The second, less than 12. From the 7 speeches, all of them, the 7 speakers can less than 15 minutes. Only one can 18 minutes, that he spoke for 18 minutes. And that was Socrates. And Socrates, though, he was reading, half of his presentation was reading another paper that was prepared by great Greek ancient female philosopher, Diotimus. And because they were not allowed, Socrates read her paper. So Socrates actually used some of his time to present another paper to not allow it. Now we have some people here, believe it or not, that they think that they are Socrates and they want more than 15 minutes to present. Who are you? I mean, who are you? The Socrates citation index is mostly infinite because you divide by zero, you don't matter. Still people cite. Anyway, that was the idea. Of course, democracy, freedom is very important for academic meetings. Here you can say anything you like. Nobody will dare to say that you don't have the right to speak. But they can say that I don't believe you, I don't like you. And we had a lot of these things in ancient Athens. As an Athens, as a city, this is from a very big liar, well-known politician of the ancient times, Pericles. He was a very big liar, fake news, whatever. He's a person, unification of that, what we call today a modern politician. Thucydides, of course, that he taped his speeches, that's one of the speeches that he says outside the Parthenon. He said, our city is open to the world. We never expel a foreigner from learning or seeing. This was true in ancient times, because most of the academics and philosophers that you know, they were not from Athens. Aristotle, for example, not from Athens. Socrates was from Athens. So anyway, so that's we copy this model and we say, okay, let's do this. Let's do what Plato and Aristotle did in their religion. What they did, they brought people from all over the world and exchanged ideas. Okay, so now, just for this week, I'll tell you what we are doing. Since symposiums are very small, 25 people, that was in ancient Athens, we organize small events, but many small events. So if one event is gross, then we chop it. We organize another event, and another event, and another event. That's why you see so small events. But the idea is to bring people together from different disciplines. It's a trick that you don't notice, that only careful people notice it. At the end of the day, we have what we call a roundtable discussion. So this is, we bring people, academics that are involved with us to exchange ideas and just give their opinion about an issue that is globalization, which is a very good issue to discuss in an academic environment or a city like Athens. So in this week, like in this room, we should have more than 100 people coming from 38 different countries. So these are the countries. Now, some facts about Atiner. We have 2,500 members coming from 116 different countries. We have, over the years since our inception, establishment in 95, we have 20,000 researchers. We're not Mickey Mouse. That means all the names appear on the website. You can check them, see who we have presented from the best university in the world and from the worst university. Okay, this is the important thing. There are 10,000 universities around the world. There are 10 million professors, academics, and researchers. According to the only census data that we have is from the United States. There are 2 million only in the United States, researchers and academics. And of course, the top universities, unfortunately, most of the top universities are in the Anglo-Saxon world. But half of them, they are not Anglo-Saxons, the professors. So it gives you an idea of the internationality. What we do, the symposiums that I mentioned, with some universities we have signed agreements because they think that we are good in organizing, believe it or not, events, so they want to have student exchange. So with the University of Maryland every year we have student exchange, with some other universities, especially American or Canadian universities. The others, they don't have the money. We do some summer courses, but that's not our primary activity. We do a lot of research, but based upon external funding from our members. So if you want someone to host your research, we can provide. We can give you even free office space by hosting visiting research fellows, self-funding, etc. Now, this is a pain in the neck application. Let me say, even though we say that, we are not a publishing house. We don't want to become a publisher. We don't care about publication. How bloody I can put it. The publications industry is, I mean, we can discuss it forever. I can give you reference to that. We were forced to go into publications from our members because they say if you don't publish, you perish. If you don't publish, people, the university do not support us to come to the conference. This is their blackmail. And we have to yield to that plug. This is the truth of the matter. And this is very important. And we had two roundtable discussions about public publishing. It's a big business for some people. Okay. Now, what we do though, we do five publications. First of all, we publish an abstract. In some universities, abstract would come. I don't know why, but they come. I mean, an abstract would is nothing. But after 4 days, we publish the abstract with a nice ISBN number. We publish Athenaeum Conference paper series based on submission. These are not reviewed, by the way, the paper series. It's your presentation here. So we upload it because a lot of people ask for us, we upload it. Now starts the difficult part. Online paper series. These are reviewing. comes, even if you present, we have reviewed. Books, we have 200 books published, especially some books that are doing very well in law, in philosophy. We have excellent editors, and they publish an anthology of the papers presented. This is very good. This is not very good. Okay. Now, finally, the worst thing, the journals. In 2016, someone had a great idea to start publishing journals. You know how difficult it is? I found out. First of all, we had to face all this private publishing. Let me tell you something about our journal. We have a unique blind review process. What it means, it's an open access review process. I don't know if you are familiar, it's unique. In other words, if your paper is submitted, it goes to an editor. If it is accepted for reviewing, we check for originality. I don't like the word plagiarism, the originality, but one minus originality defines plagiarism. Now, and we uploaded a blind version. Here is the site. You can see hundreds of papers here. And then we are receiving reviews out of that. Apart from the two blind reviews, you might end up with 50 reviews, 50. People read your work because they don't know your name. So they don't see your name. And they comment on that. So we send you the comments and we take them into consideration. To test this, just to give you an example, to test this, I wrote a paper, which I thought, because it's my paper, it's one of the best papers in the world. Now, what happens is, I got, without knowing my name, I got 50 reviews, 50 reviews, 25% flatly rejected, 30% flatly accepted, and minor major revision between. But the comments were excellent, because I'm not going to publish it, because, in honor of our journal, because there is conflict of interest. But I want to see how it works. There are people, there was an American professor got 10 comments and she got upset because she said 10 comments. What is that? 10 different reviews. You should be happy, 10 people read your work. If you put your name, maybe nobody would read it. So it's better that it's a blind review because people get curious because they don't see the name. Otherwise, a lot of people, they say, ah, that's not a good paper, what do we expect? An American professor writes about Middle East politics, that's not true. They reject just because you're an American, for example. But here they don't know, they understand because your English is good, if you're an American, so they understand. Now, the second thing, please circulate this. We don't ask for money. Look at this, fee for submission, no. Processing, no. Publishing, no. Open access paid by authors, no. Open access paid by readers, no. These are the tricks that they make money. So the private publisher, no. But then public publishing companies. This, at Atiner, it's free. And the final thing is the intellectual property rights. We don't transfer intellectual property rights laws. You keep it as an offer. Now, our acceptance rate right now is 40% for all our journals. It was 25%, but it increased because a lot of people find out that we're not a Mickey Mouse publisher and we don't submit it. And some of them are flatly rejected. But we do need help. That's why it takes some time. Please, if you have the time and you don't lack money that you want to make it out of editing, please help us because we want to improve. We want to become better. And I think our journal will become better. And they start being indexed. But still, it's a lot of work. We are very good editors. You can check. We have 6,000 people. Their names appear on the site that they have voluntarily offered their services to do reviewing, 6,000 people. But we don't put them, this is the potential reviewers, we don't put them in the reviewers list until they actually review it. So you can understand, because right away, because say, some people they say, put that in the board. Board requires a lot of work. We're not going to put you in the board right away. Get involved, as I said, become a member. This is some. Since you paid the fee, you don't have to pay the entrance fee. We block that to people that they don't know us, so they cannot become members. Second thing is that the annual fee is very low, and you can do a lot of things, especially if you like what we are doing with Atiner. A lot of things. And one of these organized a small event, review of course the papers that I mentioned. We can collaborate in organizing a course. Whatever else you want, pending that we have the money and the time to do it. Now, I have already mentioned all the presentation will take 15 minutes. At the end, I ask the chairs, especially the chairs that don't have experience with us. We follow the North American style of chairing. In other words, chairs, they are administrators. They don't comment on the papers presented. That's the continental European style. So the chair, a good chair, is the chair that keeps his or her mouth shut. They don't comment on the papers. They keep the time, and then at the end, they open up the discussion. If you see that people do not have questions, leave them to go outside and you will see the discussion will start. This is very important what I'm saying because a lot of people, believe it or not, I'm going to reveal a secret. English is not the only language in the world. There are people that their mother tongue was not English. So they are scared when they, can I put you, come here and speak in Greek? Even if you read it. And works if I ask you in Greek. And you respond. So we have to be very careful because we don't want, especially for the young researchers that they come here, to have a trauma because of some people, some British, American, only unilingual people, they ask questions. And particularly, I found out something out of 20 years of experience. I don't know why, when they ask someone that doesn't speak English very well, they use the most uncommon adjectives in the world. I mean, they use what I should say, like Oxfordian English, 19th Victorian English. Even themselves do not understand the adjective that they use. And now it's okay. But they use so strange adjectives. Instead of saying good, for example, bad, they use this. People can understand you, especially if here, that the chair's responsibility to take care of. And some people believe that they don't speak English very well. They are good researchers, but they are scared when they face an audience in another language, okay? So, chairs, please. Now, the problem is old. Look what Socrates said. Socrates was fed up with some people that they were talking forever. So he's in place for Protagoras, he says, look, I'm fed up. Elect a judge, or a foreperson, or a chairperson, I have translated. So you keep the length of each one's speech short. 2,500 years, we had academics that they want to talk more than 15 minutes. So that's the mean to have a good chair, okay? So that we talk only for 15 minutes and attend the discussion. Now, we have some other things that I don't really want to promote. We have social events. Unfortunately, we have to have a conference with social events, great nights, cruises, but this is not part of what we like to do. What we like to do is the 2 days. And we like to do the academic things. Now, I know that many people, they come for the cruise, they come for the, especially the first time. But over the years, we have people that they are coming only for the academic part of it. And we know that because they come only for 2 days and they leave. For us, it's a great satisfaction. For me, it's great satisfaction. And our conferences, they are the worst conference organized in the world according to the criteria of enjoyment. This is the worst area of Athens. I warn you, this is, you have to be careful, it's the worst part of Athens. It's dirty, it's noisy, it's not a resort hotel, this one. It's a downtown hotel. And I'm saying that not because I want to apply reverse psychology. I'm saying that because it's true. Yeah. So when your dean says you go and enjoy yourself in a nice beach in Athens, it's not true, because you come to the worst place, whatever it is. So please, of course you can go to the cruise, I'm not going. Of course you can go to the Greek night, I might be. And all the others, I mean, there are some good things, like you go to Delphi for the first time. And of course with a German professor, you don't have a lot of German because they go to the island straight, they don't stop enough. So the German was a good German professor, and he came before the opening, and I closed with that. And said, Gregory, I want to ask you your opinion, it's very important for me. I thought it was something with the problem. And someone went wrong, and he was very serious. I said, you know, should I go to the cruise or not? I didn't want to see. I said to myself, no, you should not go to the cruise. I got up at 10. It's from 6 o'clock till 8 o'clock in the night. It's tiring. You go to 3 islands. I mean, who wants to see 3 islands? Nobody. So the weather would be sunny. Sunny, you know, so good. You can swim there. Why you swim? You should go to the library, I said, the public library here, and go and study on Wednesday. I'm not lying. On Wednesday, and do your work. We have a very good public library. Nobody goes there, but now it moved, but that those years was next to us. So the nice building, you go to the public library, stay there all day and read. And then, why you ask me something that you know I know that? Then finally he went, because he didn't follow my advice. Thank you very much for being here. I'll be around. If you want really to discuss academic things, collaborations, I'll be at your disposal. But if you want my opinion about the social event, please don't ask me. Now, we have very good social, we have very good administrators. Whatever has to do with administration, we shouldn't ask them. In each room, there is a researcher with a master's degree, believe it or not, to help you with all the details and the logistics of the conference. All the people that are responsible for this small event that's organized this week, they are here. Vicky Hughes is here. David Fregel is here. Mike Malloy is here. I don't know if do I miss anybody? No? No. Okay, so they're going to be around, and I'll see you most probably tonight, if not during the lunch. Thank you very much.